Hey, good morning, everyone. OrbCom is a publicly traded company, one of the largest right now in IoT and the transportation sector. We're very unique because we own our own satellite constellation. We were actually SpaceX's very first customer when we replenished our satellite network 2.5 years ago. We have over 2 million subscribers today, and other businesses other than transportation include heavy equipment, oil and gas, and vessel tracking. But we're here today mostly to talk about our transportation offering. About 1.2 million subscribers on the transportation side, companies including Maersk, J.B. Hunt, Swift, Hub Group, Hapag-Lloyd, and many, many more. We provide a full and complete visibility to your assets, whether it be tractor or trailer. We specifically dominate the refrigerated telematics space. We have probably about a 70% share of the refrigerated telematics market, and we offer full control and visibility to your refrigerated assets. On top of that, we're a multimodal offering. So we also offer rail car, flatbed, dry van, all on the asset side, pretty much everything that's out there. Recently, we've gotten into the in-cab business, fleet management business, with two recent acquisitions. And so it gives us hours of service and ELD, as well as driver scorecard and driver behavior.
Yeah, thanks, Chris. I'd like to take it from there. So what we're going to look at today is the Fleet Manager application by OrbCom. This is a cloud-based analytics and information platform designed to give fleets one comprehensive location to track different asset classes and different asset types, including drivers, equipment, trailers of all different sizes and types. As Chris mentioned, we talked about the refrigerated control asset. That allows us to do not only two-way command and control of the unit, but also feeds a tremendous amount of analytics data behind the scenes. We look at location data, we look at arrival, departure events, temperature in transit. We're key in the FSMA compliance aspect for refrigerated fleets. We do an automated recording process from reefer switch on to reefer switch off. Basically what that means, from the pre-cool period all the way through transit and final delivery, we know every temperature from every sensor on that trailer, including remote probes and the OEM sensors that are included in it. We take that data, culminate it in the background, and store that information for the fleets to be able to retrieve for on-demand delivery requirements. So when they hit destination, they can either provide an electronic copy or they can use that data via our APIs. That allows you to have pre-cleared deliveries on arrival. So when you get to the big box stores or the big delivery locations, you know exactly what the temperatures were from the time it loaded onto your trailer till the time the doors closed until it hit destination. So what we're going to start out here is the four major modules that work with the application itself: dispatch, temperature, hours of service, and vehicle exceptions. It's a very flexible application. It's highly configurable. Each individual user can come in and choose how they want the screens to look at. They can choose the configuration and the layout options. They can also choose the modules or the widgets that display within that screen. So a standard application that we're looking at here is on the power unit itself. We have a driver who has begun his trip earlier this morning outside of Amarillo, Texas. He's within the Dallas-Fort Worth market currently. We have general information on the driver, where he is, his hours of service, what regulations he's running, when his duty start time was this morning, and what he has left on his cycle count as well. And then we move into an actual look at the driver's hours of service. So you can see a complete listing and a breakdown on the lower right-hand corner indicating when his duty status started, what the duty events that he had recorded within the transit time as well, including any violations that may occur within that driver. And then you see not only that location, but you have the last 7 days worth of data history as well. You can also go back and use the calendar icon on any one of the screens, allowing commonality to pull recent history or past history if you needed to retrieve that for any purpose. Of course, all this data comes in from our in-cab product that the driver has in his power unit, fully compatible and supportive of all ELD mandates today, including the ability to hand it over to an inspection officer should he need to do an inspection with that equipment. Other aspect around here is the temperature management piece. The bottom right-hand corner, we have bottom left-hand corner, we have a graph presentation down here, and what you see presented here is a pre-cool period of a refrigeration unit. You'll see the temperature bands from the power on event, where you had an air temp of 66.5 degrees in that trailer Fahrenheit. You'll see the trailer doors were closed, and then you begin to see that trip you begin to see the temperature records for that trip itself. All of this data is exportable. It also feeds through the API in real time with our integration partners. Whether that's a TMS, a YMS, or a visibility partner, we support all of this data in the back end as well. So we're picking up temperature data, we're picking up the driver data, we know when the doors close, we know in a dry van application, we know cargo status, so we know when the trailer arrives, we know when the doors open, when the cargo state changes to the time the doors close, to the time it departs. All of that data goes in behind the scenes, and similar to what Craig was talking about earlier, we know detention time at every location, we know how long it takes your driver to arrive at a location, how long it takes that facility to unload the trailer, to get the driver turned back out, and improve his utilization and turn time. Consequently, on the refrigerated side, we know the snapshot of every refrigerated unit when it arrives at a shipper. We capture runtime, engine hours, fuel consumption, and time on location. All of that feeds into a detention module, so you can capture data in excess of dwell time. You can also capture fuel consumption and runtime. It helps you identify abusive situations or shippers that may be using your equipment in an unauthorized state. Vehicle reports and exceptions, everything that comes out from a driver DVR to an unassigned miles can be fully rectified and accounted for within the application. You can make the updates here within the application itself, pushes the data back down to the driver. Driver will then verify and either acknowledge or send back an exception for any of those events that are in that group. And then the last aspect around this is the reporting. So there's a little bit of a gamification here for the driver. He's not only getting judged on the equipment, but also his comprehensive driving skills. We're looking at fuel compliance, we're looking at cruise control, we're looking at usage of idle time and anticipation score. Anticipation score is a great role to look at how safe a driver is. Lets us identify how long does it typically take that driver to take his foot off the throttle, move it to the brake pad. Kind of helps you identify drivers that are paying attention. So this has been kind of a high-level overview on the application for Fleet Manager and Orbcom. I appreciate your time. We're located at booth 103. Please come by and see us, and if you have any additional questions. Thank you.
Thank you.